Hi, welcome to the Boerma Institute. My name is Jacqueline Boerma. I'm going to give a live stream today. I'm making a Dutch garden. Well, actually a table arrangement, not necessarily a Dutch garden. I'm using some bark and I'm also using some moss. We wired it and we did that with glue and some wood underneath and some thick wires. A special warm welcome to our patrons. Hello, how are you today? Thank you for watching. I'm cutting some of the wires because some of them are quite tall, long. Mike is not here today, but we will be fine. Sinsin is here, Angelica is here, Axel is here, and also we have a big help today from Aneta. Aneta is one of our former students of the Professional Advanced and Master course. And she's also a very special DFD club member. The DFD club we have once a month on Thursday evening, always the second Thursday of the month. And it's specially for our students and former students. So my name is Jacqueline Boerma. I'm the owner of the Boerma Institute. If you are here for the first time, welcome. The Boerma Institute is a private school run by my family members. Mike, my eldest son, Angelica is his partner, and then Axel is also working in the school. And he does the web shop, so Floral Design, that's Floral Design Supplies, right? .nl. You can buy those materials that you see here. Our 8 materials, like the wire, the stop wire, the Oasis. I'm using, by the way, Oasis biodegradable. It's 91% biodegradable. And we sell that also in all different kinds of shapes and sizes. I'm using some moss. And it's going to be my base of the arrangement. My moss and the bark is the base of the arrangement. And this arrangement can be placed on a side table, but also, for example, on in an office or at a shop or bank, whenever you have an entrance and you need something tall and not so wide. I'm also having some beautiful in season, hop. So, Humulus lupulus is the Latin name. I'm going to use that as a spiral going through the arrangement. Keep turning my arrangement. I could use a Lazy Susan in this case. I don't have one under my counter, but this way it will do also. Just putting them in. Some of them are wired, some of them are not. It's also now in season. I bought a very nice plant online. Not a very good thing. This is my plant. See? So I will plant it this autumn, and then I hope it will grow into something like this, beautiful. So we don't have to go to the Gulpener Brewery to cut some of their hop. Normally we go there once a year in September, and then you can help them with cutting the hop, and they use it in the beer, in their beer. So I'm making the base at this moment, and then later on I will use some vertical flowers to go in between. But it's nice to fill this space up first and then give it some more rest or peaceful material. Persicaria, very beautiful stuff. I just got a plant like this from the nursery, from the flower nursery Morning Glory. It's Persicaria orientalis. Very nice one. And the English name is a very nice one. What was that again? Kiss me over the garden gate. Yeah, that's a nice word. We don't have those romantic names in Holland. I think the English, although they are not really famous for their romance, I think they have a lot of romance in the garden. This is the pimpernel. The pimpernel is the Sanguisorba. Also from the nursery from Chris. I'm using that vertical because it grows that way. Oh, is that broken? Yep. Let me change that. Angelica.
Yes, so we have a few people in the chat.
Oh, nice.
We have Angela saying, hi guys, just made it, but I won't be commenting.
Ah, that's a pity, but thank you for watching, Angela. Nice that you're here again.
We have Taiwan giving thumbs up.
Hello, Taiwan. Thank you for watching again. Thank you for translating also all these kinds of things for the teachers.
And a question from Angela.
Yeah.
Why buy hops? They are classed as weeds and grow wild here. What variety hops?
I don't know the variety because it's sold as hops, not a special brand. I know that they have the ecological or the bio hops in the south of Holland. They make the Gulpener beer from that. But I don't know this variety. I bought it under the name of hops. Here, it does not grow in the wild. In the south of Holland, maybe, because they grow it there also. So there might be some wild ones. I know in Germany it grows in wild also, but not here in Holland. Yeah.
Okay, so Angela said, I lied, haha, smiley face with tears.
Oh, okay.
And we have a Sally Hardy saying hello from Berkshire, UK.
Hi, Sally, thank you for watching.
And Taiwan says, thumbs up, I see. It is for beer.
Yes, it is for beer, yes. It gives the taste, it gives the, hoppy flavor to it. And this goes up a little bit higher. I like to have the green also up there and a little bit wild. So the green of the Persicaria is also connecting, and the wildness of the Persicaria is also connecting with the wildness of the hop. And then I also have some nice, very nice Cotinus. Cotinus, this is not the classic variety. The classic variety is green. This one is dark red. Axel, can you see that? It's beautiful. And in Dutch it's called een pruikenboom. Guess why? Maybe? So I place that vertical. And then take off this leaf because I think this leaf is touching that one too much. And then I will place this one lower to get some more depth in it. Oops, sorry for the noise. I should sharpen my knife probably. Now I'm throwing these little leaves away, but I actually shouldn't, because these nice little leaves are very good for corsages. So maybe I should keep them, so the international course can take this afternoon and practice the corsages in the weekend. Yeah.
Yes, so Angela says that she grows the hops and uses them as wreaths.
It's beautiful. Sure.
And Sally Hardy says hops, very invasive, and had to take it out of my garden, took over.
Yeah, it depends on where it grows and what the soil conditions are. I had hops in my former garden. And then it also took over. But in my aunt's garden in the south of Holland, Tante Annie, so hi, if you're watching, Tante Annie, hope you're there. Then it did not take over at all, but she had it also next to the pebbles, grind. So when it grows, it could not grow in between that. So it didn't take over the whole scenery. But I love hops. I love the way it grows. And you can make, in what you said, Angela, you can make rhesus with it. But you can also do a lot of things about it with garlands and things like that. Oops. So where is that noise come from? Oh, I have probably some wire underneath my container. Yeah, I think so. I'm adding some carnations. The carnations are adding some color at the base as well. I'm using it more or less as moss, so not separate flowers, but as a cover.
Yep. Yes.
Sorry about the noise again.
Question from Taiwan.
Yeah.
Is this a garden design?
No, actually it's not. It's more like a parallel or freestyle arrangement in this case. Could be a garden design though, but no, I don't. I group some things. I don't group all of it. So the persicaria and the sanguisorba are not grouped. So more parallel. But well, maybe just my messy style. Yeah.
Yes, we have Lisa Florista in the
chat. Hi, Lisa. Lisa, nice that you are joining us again.
And she's saying, happy birthday, beautiful.
Oh, yes. Thank you very much again. Thank you all for the birthday wishes. I tried to answer them. I did today because last night we were working. We had the DFD club and I did not have time to answer all these messages. Thank you all for your birthday wishes. Thank you very much. Yeah, 1 year older again. But still alive and kicking, right? Keep going. Hopefully for a long time. Because it's such a fun occupation. You can do this all year, or every year, every day, at every age. I'm using some clematis to go at the base as well. So the color from the pink and the green goes up all the way. I'm having some, where is the other one? Oh, it disappeared. Yep. I have two zinnias from my garden. And I need to have them on a prominent space because that were the only two in my garden. But they're beautiful. So nice color, nice popping color. There. Keep turning the arrangement because it's an all-sided arrangement. Oh yeah. Remember this one. Lavatera. Very nice. I used this. When did I do exam? I think 86. I used this for my national floristry exam. Well, you had to make an arrangement for that you had to bring yourself. The flowers you had to bring yourself. And then you could choose several arrangements. I choose a table arrangement. And then I had Lavatera there. Very nice flower. And it also is a little bit the shape of the clematis. So, but a little bit different color. Oops, this one could go a little bit more to the there. Because I have some space here. If I didn't put the bark there. Yeah. Yep. Like that. Then I have some beautiful dahlias. I have some dahlias in my garden, but no pink ones. They're red. And I think last time, 14 days ago, Mike showed you around the garden a little bit. And it was just planted because I got the plants from the small plants from Morning Glory. And then now it's really getting together. Maybe I can group that. Let me group those three together. Otherwise, this one is lonely. Like that. Yeah, I think so. Are you looking for any names, Angelica?
Because there is a question from Taiwan.
Yeah.
May I know the name of these purple-pink flowers?
Purple-pink flowers. These ones.
I think it was, yeah.
Yeah, Lava Terra. It's not on the board, sorry. No, I just added them.
Oh, my spelling really sucks, so... I'm going to do my best.
L-A-V-A, Lava Terra. T-E-R-A. Thank you, Angela. So, some snowberries. Symphoricarpus. Got them yesterday from the auction, but dry out a little bit. But it's late summer, early autumn arrangement, so I don't mind that it's a little bit drying. So, is everything all right with you? The noise is, the sound is good, I hope. What shall I do? Missing something here, right? Yeah. Using some more grasses, also in the dark tone of the cotinus. And of course, I just said the name and now it doesn't pop up. Maybe it has something to do with age. Is it in the way, Axel? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Je weet wel.
Yeah.
You know. Never mind. Angela will help out, I hope. Thank you, Angela. Or maybe even Taiwan. Maybe they can help out. And otherwise we'll look it up. Or maybe it will pop up later in my mind. I don't know. Keep turning. I think I could use some more pink here to balance the other pink of the dahlias on the other side. You guys are quiet today. No more questions, nor no questions at all. Any remarks? The weather here in Holland was kind of hot the last 3 days. In the rest of the summer, we had a lot of rain, but now it started to be nice. And from today, I think we are going to get rain again. But all through the summer, I think, how many days did we have sun? Not so many. Not that I can remember. In the other classroom, we are here in the second classroom. In the other classroom, we have the international course. Six students that are going to do the international course in 5 weeks. Proost, trouwens. So at the end of the course, September 30, they will do the examination. And on Friday, what was that, Friday 22nd? We are also going to Fleur Amour with the group. So we're going to visit Fleur Amour because then it's nice that the event can start again. Yeah.
The grass is miscanthus.
Yes, of course. Thank you very much. Yeah. Yes.
We have Sharon Linton saying, beautiful, lovely to see you again, Jacqueline.
Hi, Sharon, thank you very much.
And Lisa Florista says, I love the colors and the transparency.
Oh, thank you, Lisa. Well, this is also more or less it. If I look from a distance a little bit, then I think it will be fine. It could use one more miscanthus somewhere there. Yeah.
Taiwan says, it is still very warm here in Taiwan, and there will be a typhoon this weekend.
Oh, wow. So please take care. I hope it will miss Taiwan. Hope it will not be too much damage. So take care, please. Be safe. And let us know how you're doing there. Yeah.
Question from Angela. What countries are coming for the international course?
Angelica, my Axel, what countries do we have for the international course? We have Bahrain? No? I'll have to look that up. England, two ladies from England, but most of the people that are joining the international course now are people who live in Holland for like 5 years, something like that, because we cannot have people from other countries like South Africa. There was supposed to be somebody coming from South Africa, but she couldn't make it because she didn't get a visa because of, you know, situation all over the world. So yeah, we have only 6 students. But hopefully January will be better, and then we have some more students, international ones. The Dutch courses are going very well, actually, because the Dutch courses, we have the professional course starts with 15 people in the daytime, one day a week, and the evening course has 14 students. So that's also a nice group to start with. As you see, I have made some bark here, some moss, so they're alternated with the carnations at the base. Then I alternate the green, the brown, and the pink. So we have them in groups and sometimes also separate flowers singly. So it's a little bit transparent. And it's a nice arrangement for a desk or for a side table. So I think I shouldn't add some more. No, I think it will be fine. Yeah. You have a question?
Almost hit or the a microphone. Remark? A remark from Angela. She says, if UK come, then we have to isolate for 10 days.
Oh, well, I hope it will change in November when you're coming for the master course with Gregor. And otherwise, you're welcome to stay 10 days beforehand and then join the course, Angela, if you can spare the time.
Yes, and Taiwan says the border of Taiwan is still closed.
Still
sadly.
Closed. Yeah. So hopefully, and this is Aneta. Hopefully it will change soon. So that's on the side. Yeah. Then this was the first arrangement. If you have any questions about it, please ask. And I will wiggle my second arrangement. Yeah, well, I hope the water doesn't spill. don't tip it, eh? Well, you've probably seen this container before. Sinsin, say hi.
Hi.
Thank you. I'm making a cascading bouquet. Arrangement.
That's a big bouquet.
That's a big bouquet. Well, if you've seen the pictures from the old days, you can see that we have made a big bouquet, even bigger than this, hand-tied bouquet, for the International Flower Fair in November, years ago. I think it was 83 or something like that. So this is my cascading bouquet arrangement. I have used some cotoneaster, this one. That's cotoneaster. It has some nice orange berries. I got it from our neighbor's garden, but it was growing on our side. So cotoneaster, and the cotoneaster in Dutch is also dwergmispel. And then I've used some pistachia in there, and also some lemon leaves. What else? No, that was it for now. Ja. Deze kant. Wiggle, wiggle. Beter? It's better like this? Yeah? Okay, then we'll do it like that. And then I also got some small rose hips from the flower auction. And actually, I think they're from Erik Stockman. So Erik, hi, if you're watching, I'm using your rose hips. I'm using that cascading. It's going to be cascading to one side. So on this side, it will be... Yep. On this side, it will be longer. And it's cascading from all over the place. Yeah.
So, first of all, Lisa Florista says, gorgeous design about the previous one.
Oh, thank you.
And Angela says, what style was it? And explain 3-5-8.
In the other arrangement? Or in this arrangement?
That I'm not sure.
Oh, please don't let me explain 3-5-8. It was there with the container. And, yeah. I will show you later on the photos. If Mike does the edit, he will do the 3-5-8 in it. Yeah? And Sinsin also. So that one is going up a little bit. There. Yeah. Then this one goes in front. Maybe a little bit shorter. This looks weird from this side. I still have an issue with the camera angle. Oh, and it's messy over there. Kun jij mijn tas daar weghalen, Axel? Die is echt heel lelijk. Dank je.
So Angela says it was about the first
thank
one.
You.
And she also says that it's fine that you explain later.
Thank you very much. Then I'm using the small rose hips. Rosallo heette die. The small ones. And those are from Erik. And he also sells them in Reese's. And I'm also using some, where are you? I'm still in there, yeah. It's one big mess of wild clematis. They get tangled. Yep. Oh, it's one. Here you go. Now you're not. The nice thing about the clematis is always it grows into the trees. And you cannot see where it starts and where it stops. Yeah, there it is.
Is it from the garden?
Yes, it's from the from the city garden.
Oh. Ah, the city garden, yes.
The city garden on the other side of the street.
Nice, good supplier.
Yes. And they grow it, cut it once a year, and they do it so ugly to cut it like that. So I think I can help them a little bit and do it a little bit nicer.
Well, so what they do is not cutting because it looks broken.
Yeah, it's a terrible way of cutting the trees. So I'm helping them a little bit to make it a little bit more tidy. I'm taking off some of the leaves because it's too messy. Yeah, and this one can be off too. There. Yeah.
A question from Taiwan. What was the name of the green branches?
The green branches that I used before, that is Cotoneaster. It's on the board. So it's a little bit wild. I'm very wild today because last night it was a little bit late. We had a nice sleepover with Angelica. No, don't want to use that. Thank you.
Hey, it was fun staying here again. It has been a while.
Like the old days.
Yeah.
Oh, kijk. Zie je hem? There's a snail in it. We have to make sure that he doesn't get a headache when we put him outside. Oh, dankjewel. So, the second one. I think that can go in between. Waar is dat? Yeah. There. Toch ziet het er anders uit op beeld, hè? It looks different on the camera. Yeah, that could do. And then this is from my garden. Some nice amaranthus. I hope I don't upset Mike now, because he was so fond of it, and it was growing next to the front door, but I cut it, and he's not here, so. Using some amaranthus, the dark color in there. Missed the container. Yeah, like that. And then we could do some going up straight with the pimpernel, with the the Sanguisorba. Yeah.
So, a question from Taiwan about the Cotoneaster.
Yeah.
Taiwan says, not the red fruits, but Cotoneaster also turns red eventually, right?
Yeah, correct. Yeah, they're still orange now. They were green months ago. Now they're orange, and then it can also turn into red.
Oh, wait, it's the one. Oh, I messed up, sorry. It's not the one with the green berries. The green berry one is the rose hip.
So the Rosa Corolla. Yeah. Nee, Rosa. Never mind. That's the rose hip. Correct. So there are small rose hips. And going to the orange a little bit. I'm using these also to give it a little bit depth. Helenium. Yes.
Correcting my mistake. So we have Tomasi in the chat saying greetings from Washington State.
Hi, nice that you're here also joining.
And Lisa Florista says, I love the long curving lines.
Yeah, it's nice and wild. Eh? It's especially something for you, Lisa, I think. It's more like your style of arrangement.
And we have a question from Angela.
Yeah.
Are you using buried ivy?
Buried ivy? No, I'm not. No, not in this case, not in this arrangement. And it's kind of weird because I have it in my garden. I could have used it. Oops, sorry. I could have used it for my garden. But it's more like a garden, like an outside seasonal arrangement in this case. Because it also the dahlias could have been growing in my garden. And the hop could be growing in my garden. 1, 2, zit ik nu aan deze kant? Ja. Yeah. There. And then I also have some. It's getting wilder and wilder. This could be off. Yes, yes. Thank you. Yes.
Yes, question from Angela.
Yeah.
What are the grasses at the top?
The grasses at the top? These ones?
Yes, I think that
yeah,
one.
Yeah, that's the Sanguisorba again. That's what I used also in the other arrangement going up. And these rose hips are also from the city garden. Thank you, Alsmeer, for growing such nice stuff outside my house. So the orange is coming there. This one doesn't have any hips. So let's find one with some more hips. There, this one I think. Yep. Love the rose hips at this moment. You can also make a nice marmalade, chutney, thingy.
Marmalade, jam.
Marmalade, very, very healthy marmalade out of it. But I prefer to use it in my arrangement.
So, Jacqueline.
Yes.
How long will the materials from the city garden stay fresh?
At least a week. Because I have cut them and then I use them, I put them on water and then they can last for quite a while. So, yeah, like at least a week, yeah. Yeah.
So a question from Angela, and this is a bouquet?
No, I put it in Oasis. I put it actually in a block of biodegradable Oasis, like a Corso block. So normally you have 20 blocks in a box, but we also sell them with 3 in a box and with 1 in a box. And this one is 1 out of 3. So a kind of big block to use, because I have quite a large amount of flowers and materials in there. But yesterday or the day before, Irma made a cascading bouquet I think it was, Irma did that, I think. With the professional course, she made a cascade bouquet, and then after that a cascade arrangement in a vase. So it's also one of the subjects of our professional course and advanced course. Thank you. They like each other a lot. Thank you. Thank you all. There you go. Which side does it go? No, a little bit down there. Yeah. So it's a little bit more separate from the other arrangement, from the other flowers. Yeah.
We have Dunja in the chat saying, wow.
Hi, Dunja. Thank you for watching. Well, you see it next week when you get back to school. We will put it in the hall where we have some space. I think that would be good because get some air up there. Sometimes you have to look away a little bit. Where is that? There. I think it needs to go here. Yeah. Diep. Nog een beetje dieper. Ja, zo, is correct. And then, let's see. I think it's a waste to put it on the back. The back will be against the wall, so the back won't, there will be no people living. Normally I would say always cover the back. In this case, it's an arrangement that will be in the hall. So therefore, it doesn't need... Zit hij daar? Ja. I think it gives some... Waar ben je? Ja. Yeah. It will give some depth there too, and it elongates the arrangement. Thank you. I will go on with one earring and a dopje. Thank you. Well,
broke earring.
Yeah, it dropped out. I don't know. Didn't want. It's too hot for my earrings.
Drop it like it's hot.
It's so hot in here. And then I have a very nice string of, see, ta-da, and it will go there underneath that. There. Kan die nog een klein beetje omhoog? I will connect it with a piece of wire, and then actually I shouldn't use the wire, but I think in this case it can be, I don't have the binding wire from Oasis with me, so I will use just a normal wire, but I want to get it up a little bit, otherwise it hangs down too straight, but I want to connect it to this one, there, so you can see it a little bit better. There. Yeah, it just dropped out of the... Yeah, it hangs down all the way. So... And then I'll have some nice clematis again. Yeah.
Yes, question from Angela.
Yeah.
The heavier stems, you didn't wire them?
The heavier stems, no. I only wired the hop that was going inside because I wanted to have it a little bit more, I wanted to give it a little bit more support. But all the other stems I didn't wire. Yeah, to get also some pink or some darker pink on this side. Yeah, filling in the gap. Well, this one was broken, so I'll put it in the back without wasting it. And I still see something here. I hope this one, yeah, I'll take off this one, this leaf, and then these two. Yep. To go, yeah, there.
Thank you.
But I want to have it a little bit more upwards. Striving upwards, would Brigitte say, something like that. Where is this one? No, on the other side. Oh, deze is het. Oh, but those are the rose hips, but they look like white a little bit. But they're green, so I don't know if you see that, but here, from here it looks like white. Okay. Sorry, yes.
Angela says that you've lost the amaranthus.
I've lost the amaranthus. Sorry, where did I lose
Maybe
it?
Maybe one is hiding somewhere, I don't know.
There. And then there. Like that? You see? Yeah.
Nice. Taiwan says very elegant.
Sorry. Thank you very much. Ik heb een kriebel in mijn keel.
Need some water?
Yes, please. So I put some of the cotinas there. Thank you.
Ooh, thirsty.
Lekker, lekker. It's almost 4 o'clock, hè? So, and it's Friday, so we can be thirsty on a Friday afternoon. Let's see. I think I need it on the other side. I think I need it. There. It can be those two together. Yeah. And then I still have a nice bun. And that will go there. Okay. Oh, yes. I still have some apple. Thank you very much. From my garden. From my apple tree. I almost, I cut off a limb. So, sorry for him. That could be here, right? Yeah. Little wild, little small apples. They are edible if you cook them, but the birds love them too. So I leave them. I leave the others for the birds. Just Angela, I don't need to wire if I push it in deep enough inside the oasis, and my oasis is big enough to hold these kinds of stems. So make sure that you use the right size oasis. Then I also have some vlier. I think you can make a jelly out of it together with apples. So I thought it's a nice color, and we can, it's a nice combination. Oops, spider, go away, thank you. It's a nice combination with the apple that I use, so therefore I use it inside. This is also with compliments of the city garden. Maybe I should put it together with the apples, so you can see why. I have them in there. Yeah. Sounds funny. Who was that?
That was me. I had a hiccup.
Nice. Yeah. So apples and vlier. I don't know the English name for that, but it's the sambucus. Maybe you use it also in English. Go well together. Then I have some rose hips. I have some gloriosa. They totally don't fit in my area arrangement, but I love the color with it. I use some cotinus, which also grows here in Aalsmeer, and some dahlias and other materials. So thank you very much. Sorry. Thank you for watching. Oh, cough this and then that. Okay. Well, thank you very much. I hope you have enjoyed the demonstration. And in 14 days there will be another demonstration live stream. So thank you. Thank you for watching. Oh, so bye. Everybody says bye. Aneta, jij ook, hè? Bye.